Welcome again at another Lua code demonstration. This time we are doing the Peace River layout that some of you may have seen before. Let me start it up. That is this pause signal over here that I am going to make green, and that will start the trains. The software is 100% exactly the same as the previous one. The only thing that is different is, of course, the definitions of the blocks and the routes. That's actually, if you use this software, all you need to do is to define your blocks and routes. It is explained in the software how to do that. It's not a difficult task. On the other hand, it is a task with which you can easily make mistakes, because for every definition of a block or a route, everything that you fill in needs to be 100% in order, and a mistake is quickly made. A sensor number, or you forget to place a sensor, or a junction number is wrong, or Fahrt or Abzweig is mixed up. That's why it is easy now in the new software version that we can disable routes. Every route has an enable or disable flag. And the easiest way to debug a layout is to simply disable all the routes and only enable one of them. If there is a train, let's take an example. Here is a train now. So I can enable the route of station south 1, 2, it's a cargo train, 2, station north 6. And when I make this signal green, and this is the only route that is enabled, then I know for certain that that train will start to drive, and I can follow here on my printout screen if everything is okay, and I can see if all the junctions have been switching right and if all the sensors on the receiving track are okay. So one by one, test the routes, and that makes the task a little bit easier, or at least it makes it more easy to see if there was any mistake. Alright, let's have a few minutes of traffic running around and see if there are no mistakes in this layout. I just finished the definitions of blocks and routes, and this is the first overview of all the traffic running at once. So there may still be a little flaw here or there, I don't know. We'll see. And sometimes it runs for 10 minutes and then just after 10 minutes you get a little hiccup. That is of course possible, because everything is random, and well, it is seldom that a similar situation occurs. We'll see. What we also see in this layout, we have here this south loop that is it is on the west now, but that is because this depot is usually on the north side, but we are now looking at the camera from the west hill. So this is the south loop, and that is a single track, and well, obviously, because we have 6 or 7 tracks even over here and 2 over there that all want to use that same single track, that's 8-1 that is going to ask for trouble. And it's clear to see that this single track is the bottleneck of this layout. It is constantly occupied. Well, that's good, but as you can see, there are already 3 trains waiting over here. They want to go that way, but yeah, the track is occupied. And also, these trains are actually waiting because there is no room at this station north. They can only go if one of these trains has left. Well, let's see, this passenger train is almost crossing the bridge, and that's the moment when one of these trains should go. I already can see over here, North 5 is allocated, that is this cargo train, so we can see the cargo train will go on the move now. It could have gone on the move, but this yeah, it's all random. This one went first. That can happen, of course. That means it's still allocated. Now we have to wait until the next round. maybe I should give the sensors over here a little bit more of a waiting time, which means that they are not yet available, and then these trains get a little bit more of priority. There is some fine tuning that still can take place, of course. We see yet again another train entering, and the delay is now only 15 seconds, and this is a fast train, but if here is a slow train, then that's too short, and then they all have to wait. But now my cargo train is going, so I think that would be a nice solution to give a little bit more of a waiting time delay over here. Okay, this means now there's room for this cargo train, so that's now also on the move. It will go again here to track 5. After it has passed these junctions over here, or maybe a little bit sooner even, this train sees that it's it sees that the track over here, that's also a single industry track with two-way traffic, it sees that the track is free, so it's already going over there. Well, so right now we have things on the move again a bit. Alright, I can already see in my printout window this cargo train has left station south. That makes room for one of these three, and this passenger train was allocated. If a train is a route is allocated, it prints it out over here. In the video that was obviously not possible to see, but I could see that. So there it goes, which makes room again for a passenger train. That's why this passenger train is now going here into that station. Alright, maybe I can show as soon as this passenger train leaves, then this track will become free, and at the same moment one of these three will be allocated there. So let's have a look. It's happening now. Right now we should see over here a new route is going to be requested. Yes, I don't know if it's possible to read on the video, but it says north 1 to south 2 is allocated, or allocated, it is requested. And because my delay here is not long enough, maybe this train gets priority, that's uncertain. But this passenger train here on North 1 is the one that is going to South 2 next. Well, let's see if that happens, and if it does, then we end this video. That should be any moment now that this cargo train is freeing up the track. Yeah, there it goes. So the printout seems to work well, and everything is happening according to the schedule, so to speak. Alright, I think we can close this video. This was just a demonstration of the Lua blocks and routes code that is freely available for download in the text with this video. See you in a next video, probably. Bye bye.